Outstanding efforts, excellence, and innovation related to its ongoing or special programs and services which benefit their industry, profession, or the public at large. This year's winner did all that and more. It is an association that is organized through an extensive network of chapters, work-based commissions, and geographic regions. They've donated a package, thousands of items for Operation Shoebox for the armed services, and contribute to as many as 32 community service projects annually. One of their outgoing projects is a certified college professional program that provides their members with the opportunity to earn a professional designation related to their work as a college professional and expose them to content and experiences they may not be able to obtain elsewhere. Their staff and executive director are each strong in their advocacy and volunteerism towards many causes, including advancing the profession of association management. It is my pleasure to announce the winner of the 2012 Association of the Year Award is the Association of Florida Colleges.
AFC, let's get on your feet and let's hear it from Region 1. Let's hear you, Region 2. Region 3. Region 4. And Region 5. Now let's hear from all of you from AFC.
I've been called Sly and the Family Stone all my life. Congratulations to all of you, to all of us. Every one of you are the reason that the Tallahassee Society of Associate Executives chose AFC as the Association of the Year for 2012. You should be proud of the work that you do. We, the college system, are a family that believes we can make a difference in the lives of almost 900,000 students. Every day, no matter who they are or where they come from, we encourage and support their goals and their dreams. We are the people who make a difference every day at our colleges and in our communities. Please give yourselves another round of applause, the Association of the Year. Now, this is not on the script, but I want the six members of the AFC staff to come forward and stand right in front of me here. If you don't know it, these are the folks who make this place work. Mike, Marcia, Eileen, Dave, Tina, and Adrian. Thank you, AFC staff. Thank you, guys. It's my pleasure and privilege now to call to order our 63rd annual convention. I am your 2012 AFC president, Gary Sly. Thank you all for joining me here at the Innisbrook Resort. As the Professional Association for the Florida College System Institutions and Employees, we are the people with like interests and concerns that since 1949 have been the unified voice for Florida's colleges. Today we've gathered together again to kick off our annual celebration of this great association and to highlight the great work of so many of our members. We are on the road to the future here at Innisbrook, and I am honored to have traveled the AFC path with you. I want to take a moment to recognize your state officers for 2012, and I'll ask them to come and stand forward as they call their names. Please hold your applause until all these lovely people are in place. Mr. Byron Todd from Tallahassee Community College, your president-elect. Dr. Joe Wallace from the College of Central Florida, vice president for commissions. Dr. Christina Will from St. John's River State College, vice president-elect commissions. Ms. Pat Barfield from Chipola College, vice president regions and chapters. Ms. Shelby Fiorentino from Valencia College, vice president-elect, regions and chapters, and your immediate past president, Ms. Evelyn Ward from Chipola College. Please thank your 2012 executive officers. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. I've said it many times throughout the year, the association exists to support our colleges. No entity in Florida provides more opportunities for our college employees to advance and succeed than AFC. We serve our communities through service projects locally and even here at our annual convention. No organization is better at recognizing and rewarding the excellent work of our college employees than AFC. So as we kick off this convention and showcase our system's best, brightest, and meritorious members, let us enjoy this week and all that has been carefully planned. Would you join me now in rising as we listen to the national anthem as performed by the late Whitney Houston at the 1991 Super Bowl? Remain standing as Mr. Jared Ferreira, Petty Officer Second Class, United States Navy veteran, and a student at St. Petersburg College will come to the podium and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated.
Let's thank Jared. One thing I did not say in introducing Jared is that he is not only a veteran, but he is a graduate of Pasco Hernando Community College and is currently the president of the Florida College System Student Government Association. Jared will be back a little later in the program to bring some greetings on behalf of that organization. Now I'd like to bring forward our executive director, Michael Brower, to recognize a few special people who are here this afternoon.
Good afternoon. Come on, good afternoon. Yeah, there we go. The AFC relies on our partnerships with several organizations. And this year, we are very, very lucky to have many of them back again that are with us every year. Our silver sponsor this year is Aspen University. And I just introduced myself a little while ago and spoke to Dr. Frank Trocke, who is here representing Aspen today. He is Aspen's articulation coordinator. And he has a great story because he came right from the New York area in the middle of the flood. And I know he's a little bit happy to be here in Florida right now, although I know he's a little bit worried about what's going on with his house up in Massachusetts. But we're grateful he's here and glad he is safe and he is with us. And I'd like to ask Dr. Trocke to come on up right now for a minute and provide you some words of welcome.
Thank you. And it's my pleasure to be here and representing Aspen University. And it's truly an honor to come before you. I've met some people already at our booth, and I do hope some of you, or all of you, stop by booth number 315, and we can explore a little bit more about Aspen University. Matter of fact, Aspen University, for those of you who do not know, is one of the oldest, if not the oldest, online universities in the United States. We started in 1987, and in 1987, the founder basically said two statements. Number one, I want to be able to offer a higher education degree to every single working adult in the United States. And not only that, I want that person to graduate with little or no debt. 1987, our prices, our tuition, rivals that of state universities. So please come by the booth, talk about it. We'd love to sign some articulation agreements with all of the colleges here in Florida and to give those 900,000 students a pathway to a better future. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Trocke. Please be sure to visit them at their booth. We have over 45 sponsors and exhibitors here this week, and we'll be recognizing them as we go throughout the convention. Without their support, it would be difficult for us to manage all of the costs affiliated to putting on this kind of an event. Whenever we are meeting, we are always very, very encouraged by the support we receive from the local college in the district that we are located. Here in Pinellas County, we are pleased to have one of our premier institutions, St. Petersburg College, be our district host. And their president, Dr. Bill Law, is with us here this afternoon. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Bill Law to bring you greetings from St. Petersburg College.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to have you all here today. I hope you'll take just a second. So many of my students came up to me and they're so proud to be part of it today. We think we have about two dozen St. Petersburg College students helping out here in the at the event. So give them a warm welcome if you would. all of us in Florida are so very lucky to have the positions we have, to work in the communities across the state for the improvement of the lives of our citizens. I think all of us should be rightfully proud of the work we do. One of my tasks today is to recognize somebody who helps us along the way. All of us enjoy a great deal of legislative support, and we are delighted today that we have with us Senator Jack Latvala of Clearwater. Senator Latvala was elected on November 2, 2010 to serve District 16 in the Florida Senate. This is his second term as a senator, and he previously served from 1994 to 2002. During the 98 to 2000 term, he served as the Senate Majority Leader and has earned a reputation as a tough and unwavering warrior on behalf of his causes and his constituents. Senator Latvala has been ranked in the top 10 senators in effectiveness by an annual Miami Herald poll, has been cited as a rising star by the Wall Street Journal, and has received close to 100 honors and awards for his legislative service and accomplishments. In his previous term, Senator Latvala was the sponsor of over 125 pieces of legislation that became law, including Florida Forever, which extended Florida's highly popular land preservation program and the creation of the Tampa Bay Water, which has been used as a national model for regional water supply planning. Senator Latvala most recently has served as chair of the Senate Transportation Committee, also as a member of the Senate Environmental Preservation and Conservation Committee, the Governmental Oversight and Accountability Committee, Children, Families, and Elder Affairs Committee, and of course, the Reapportionment Committee. In addition to those committees, he sits on the Budget Subcommittee for General Government Appropriations and the Budget Subcommittee on Transportation, Tourism, and Economic Development. He has been a Florida resident for almost 50 years, now resides in Clearwater, operates a printing company in Largo, and enjoys spending time with his two children and two grandchildren. Among those 100 awards, I'm just going to pick a couple from the last couple of the years. Legislator of the Year, Florida Police Benevolent Association, Shining Star for Public Education, Pinellas Classroom Teachers Association, Commitment to Quality Family Child Care from the Florida Family Child Care Home Association, Champion for Business, Associated Industries of Florida, Distinguished Alumni Award from the Independent Colleges and Universities of Florida, and Outstanding Legislative Service Award, Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office. Those are just a few of, and across the broad spectrum of all that he does. Ladies and gentlemen, a good friend for all of us, Senator Jack Latvala.
Thank you very much, Dr. Law. My privilege to be here. I guess there's somebody out there. Nobody up in the front here, but I hear sounds from the rest of the room. It's my privilege to be here to welcome you. Today, I'm the senator from the 16th district, and I'm here today to welcome you to the 11th district, which a week from today will be the 20th district. God willing, and the creek don't rise, I'll be the senator from the 20th district a week from now. This is my home, Palm Harbor, for close to 30 years. My residence was about a mile behind Innisbrook, between Innisbrook and the setting sun. Palm Harbor is a wonderful community, and Innisbrook is a wonderful place in our community that we're very proud of. We're also very proud of our colleges in this neck of the woods. Our new president, I guess he's not new, but I guess he's a couple years new, Dr. Law, appreciate your introduction and appreciate everything that Dr. Law is doing in the community. St. Pete College is a very important part of our community. Also, the last 2 years, as a senator for Pinellas and Hillsborough County in the district I've served the last 2 years, I had the privilege of working with Dr. Ken Atwater in Hillsborough. And I guess, I don't know, Ken, if you're out there anywhere, I certainly couldn't see you. But if you're here, good to see you, and thank you for all that you do in Hillsborough County. You know, Bill mentioned that when I was in the Senate before, for 8 years, I served Pinellas and Pasco counties. And in those years, I was particularly close to our, at that time, community college in Pasco and Hernando. Bob Judson was my president, a very, very good friend of mine and a very, very fine leader. And he was succeeded by Dr. Kathy Johnson, who I've had the opportunity to work with a couple times in the interim since I left office. But you do a wonderful, wonderful job here, and we appreciate it. I was going to ask Dr. Sandy Sugar to raise his hand or let me see if you're out there, but are you here, Sandy? Sandy's not here. Well, I want to recognize Sandy for a couple things. First of all, I want to recognize Valencia Community College for being recognized as the best community college in the nation in 2011. But more important and more personal, and for those of you that work there, I want you to make sure you let him know that I want to recognize him for the fact that he got my son through there. It took us three and a half years, I think, to get him through the two-year program there, but we all worked hard, and we accomplished that, and moved him on up the ladder, and it took him another 3 or 4 years to get through UCF, but he's got a degree. That's an important thing. You know, I've had the opportunity to work with many of you. Joe Pickens served with me when I was in the House, or when I was in the Senate and he was in the House, and a number of other folks that that I've seen here that have moved into positions of responsibility with our colleges and are leading to the success that that you're having out there. You know, when I was way back in the 90s, when I was in the Senate, I actually had the bill that in 1995 or 96 was the placeholder bill for Bright Future Scholarships. And it was the bill that we put it something in the middle of 1 year to actually allow the framework to be set up for Bright Futures, and then we came back the next year and Dr. Sullivan did the full bill that fleshed it out. But I am so proud of what that program has been able to accomplish, and the fact that, you know, last year that program awarded $65 million to students in our Florida college system and giving more than 42,000 students an opportunity to go to college. And, you know, that's a lot of folks, a lot of kids that wouldn't have been able to go to college otherwise. And I think that's, as I look at my accomplishments in the process, that's certainly one of the ones that I'm very proud of. I think you're going to see in Tallahassee over the next couple of years an emphasis in the legislature to try to connect what you're doing in the education system, in the higher education system in Florida, with the needs that we have in our business community. I do find, as I travel around my district and my counties, a lot of our business folks that always have seem to have an example of a type of an employee that they're looking for but they can't find. And I think it's about time that someone tried to, in an organized fashion, match up those available jobs, those new professions that are developing out of our technological age with our course offerings. And I just have a sneaking suspicion that you and your system will play a very, very important role in that. Because, you know, there's you know, education and learning, and then there's preparation for a job. And I think what you have and what you offer in your system is the ability to sort of do both and be that bridge between the facts and the education and the preparation to actually be in the workforce. Now, let me just say one other thing. I certainly hope that we're going to be able to improve on this the next couple of days, next couple of years. You know, I very much appreciate what you do as state employees. When I came back to the Senate 2 years ago, I was really taken aback by the attitude that a lot of our legislators these days have about state employees. I don't think you're second-class citizens. I think you have a very important role, and you have very great responsibilities, and you need to be treated and compensated accordingly. To me, it's embarrassing to have situations where we have right now a lot of state employees that haven't had a raise in 6 or 7 years. And you know, some of my colleagues in the legislature talk about, well, how we ought to treat state employees the way, you know, we treat private, the way people are treated in the private enterprise system. Well, I can tell you that if you work for me, you wouldn't have gone 6 years without an increase, because in the private enterprise system, most of us don't go that long without compensating our employees for the cost of living and as they move up the ladder in our organizations. So I'm very hopeful that this year, when all those pension conversations come up again, when we have to fight those battles again, that we'll be able to prevail on some of them. But I want you to know, straight from the heart, that when those conversations come up and when those fights start, you have a friend in Jack Latvala. Thank you all very much. Welcome to Palm Harbor.
Thank you, Senator Latvala, and I can personally attest to Senator's support for the FRS issues when I was testifying before the Government Accountability and Oversight Committee on this issue a couple years ago. He was always the one that asked the hard question and made the chair and the other members of that committee try to do the right thing on your behalf. Thank you, Senator Latvala. Your support of the college systems and our colleges does not go unnoticed, and we appreciate you joining us here this afternoon. And Dr. Law, thank you also, and everyone at St. Pete College, for all you have done to help us make this convention a success. As you know, we believe strongly there are strength in numbers. The AFC's unique membership and its ability to work collaboratively with all of its stakeholders enabled it to become the most dynamic association in the state. The AFC and the Florida College System are envied statewide and even nationally, and we are known for speaking with one unified voice on behalf of the Florida College System. President Joe Pickens is one of our most dynamic leaders in the system, and he is currently the chair of the Council of Presidents as well as president of St. John's River State College. I would like to now invite President Joe Pickens to the stage to please also give you a brief welcome from the Council of Presidents. Joe?
Well, Jack's right. You really do have to just take it on blind faith that there are people out there clapping and not a soundtrack. It's very, very interesting. And I appreciate, thank you, Mike, for putting up my old picture. Actually, this picture was taken 14 years ago when I ran for the legislature at the age of 39. And I've held on to it for dear life. And although I can't see them right now, there are actually four people in the audience that forced me to go to Orange Park and get a new picture taken about 6 months ago. So I do have a 50-something picture. We just don't use it. Yeah. Because after all, I'm the president and I can decide what picture we use. And lastly, my mommy likes this picture of me. On behalf of the Council of Presidents, and as the chair of the Council of Presidents, let me welcome you to AFC. And as Senator Latvala mentioned, I am a retired legislator. And it's amazing, Jack, you've been in the legislature and then out and then back in, the different perspectives you have when you're one of us or you're one of them. And so I made the transition very quickly in that regard. What I want to share with you very quickly, in addition to welcoming you and thanking you for being here, is to thank you for your membership in AFC. Mike tells you a lot how important it is for there to be large numbers, but I can tell you, as a former legislator who focused almost exclusively in education, that the voice that you carry means a lot. Now, I realize all of you are here and dues-paying members, and so I'm literally speaking to the choir. But what I would ask you to do is take the message that there is strength in numbers, and it's not okay for the 50% of the folks at your college who aren't in AFC to just count on the 50% of the folks like you that are in AFC to carry the water for everyone, even though you do. So my charge to you, and this is the charge that I will take back to St. John's River State College, is for every member of AFC to recruit a non-member to become a member next year. If we do that, then we really will have the numbers that we need to advocate, especially in Tallahassee, during the legislative session. Just recently, your voice on the issue of the continuing contract issue was listened to greatly. On almost all issues, everybody has a side. Most issues are partisan. The fact that you are an organization that is respected because you are not partisan, you're not bipartisan, you're nonpartisan. Your voice is seen as objective and as real because you are the heart and soul and lifeblood of the colleges that we serve. So on behalf again of the Council of Presidents, welcome to Innisbrook and this conference. I hope you have a wonderful time. Thank you.
Thank you, President Pickens. The Division of Florida Colleges works very, very collaboratively with our association and our colleges every day, 365 days of the year. Through its leadership and advocacy efforts, the division is a substantial supporter of the association. Since Chancellor Randy Hanna has come on at the division, he has been responsive and supportive to the AFC, and particularly on that continuing contracts issue that President Pickens just referenced. As a former college trustee, Chancellor Hanna gets it, and we know he gets it. He understands our way of life, he understands our issues, and most importantly, he understands our mission. It is my sincere pleasure to introduce our Chancellor, Randy Hanna.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the Department of Education and the Division of Florida Colleges, I welcome you to your 63rd annual FAC convention, and I congratulate you. I congratulate you not only for the successes during this past year, but throughout the history of this organization. This year's theme, A Road for the Future, is a perfect phrase to capture our role as Florida colleges, since, as you know, we're the primary path for success for more than 850,000 students every year. Keeping with that theme, we will now recognize the 2012 winners of the Chancellor's Best Practice Awards. And these are colleges who have been developing innovative strategies to educate our students in the system which is already recognized as the best in the nation. Assistant Chancellor Kasanga Butler will come to the stage to help me recognize the winners. And as she approaches the stage, I once again welcome you and encourage you to use this time together to learn and develop and share new ideas while building long-standing relationships. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. Each year, we ask our colleges at the division to submit their best practices nominations for the following categories: Academic Affairs, Business Affairs, Student Affairs, and Workforce Education. This year, we had over 31 applications submitted from 14 of our 28 colleges for the Chancellor's Best Practice Award. Again, on behalf of Chancellor Hanna and myself, I congratulate the 2012 winners of the Chancellor's Best Practice Awards. First category in Academic Affairs, we have the My Bridge to Success, St. Petersburg College, and now we'll see a little video about what their bridge to success is.
Developmental math, reading, writing, when do I get to take a course that I actually get credit for?
If I keep having to take these remedial courses, I will never finish my degree.
I can't believe it. I'm just 1 point away in my placement test from ENC 1101.
Improving success rates in developmental courses is a challenge St. Petersburg College has faced over the years. With student success as a top priority and funding from the Florida Department of Education Initiative, St. Petersburg College students have new pathways for completing course requirements. In spring 2011, St. Petersburg College began the My Bridge to Success program, offering 8-week, 2-credit courses to students in the upper levels of developmental reading, writing, and math. The goal? To reduce time and costs of remediation through instruction targeted to students' needs. Since that time, over 500 students have participated in MyBridge Reading, over 500 in MyBridge English, and almost 800 in MyBridge Math. Success rates have risen, most dramatically in MyBridge Reading, and many students have moved into transfer-level courses in the same semester. St. Petersburg College is proud to accept the Chancellor's Best Practice Award on behalf of our talented faculty, working together with students to help them reach their educational dreams.
Congratulations. On behalf of the college accepting the award is Dr. Martha Campbell and Sharon Griggs. Congratulations, St. Pete College. In our next category of business affairs, we have Broward College with the President's Leadership Academy. Let's see their video.
When J. David Armstrong became president of Broward College in 2007, he discovered that there were more than 100 members of the faculty, staff, and administration getting ready to retire from the drop program within the next 5 years. He saw a need for a succession planning program. After his experience creating the successful Chancellor's Leadership Program for the state, Armstrong had a vision to do something similar at Broward College.
The President's Leadership Academy gave me the opportunity to make a smooth transition from my faculty role to that of the Associate Dean leading several disciplines. It provided me with some of the tools necessary for budgeting, resource development, and leadership.
The Academy's mentorship component gave me the chance to work more closely with district administrators, helped me transition recently from a campus-based position to a college-wide director-level position.
There are three components to the President's Leadership Academy: participating in 7 leadership modules, including organizational culture and ethics, the legislative process, budgeting, resource management, and others facilitated mainly by internal experts. Completing a capstone project on something related to the strategic plan and student success. Mentoring provided to each group from the president's senior leadership team.
Our group's capstone project was to explore summer bridge programs that could accelerate a student's journey through their developmental courses to become college ready in just one semester.
This past summer, the college initiated the Broward College Academy for Excellence with 150 developmental students. This program is currently in the second semester with a student retention rate of over 85%.
The mentoring component needs to be enhanced to provide more opportunities for Academy participants to shadow and mentor senior level administrators. Possibly offer the Academy for 2 years with a stronger emphasis on building the capstone projects in the second year, as well as deepening the mentoring relationships, and create a Leadership Academy advisor group with a lead Academy graduate to ensure continuous improvement. Broward College is proud to receive the Chancellor's Best Practice Award.
Now we'll have Ms. Patricia Senior accepting on behalf of Broward College. Congratulations, Broward. Next, we have in the category of student affairs, Miami-Dade College's Single Stop. And their video, please.
Hi, my name is Tanisha Ewan.
My name is Julio Cohen. Single Stop helped me with tax preparation, and they also help the family get the food stamps.
I have used the assistance of Single Stop and has helped me continue to be a student here at Miami-Dade. And it's an experience that I encourage all to try.
The greatest impediment for a student's access as well as success has a name. It's poverty. Many families and students who feel that they cannot afford to pay for college.
Probably the really most compelling challenge that young people face who are often going to community colleges is the ability just to make ends meet.
The majority of students who go to community colleges are doing everything right. They've faced many barriers in their life, including having to juggle putting food on the table or paying for their books. But they're still in school, and they're still trying to make a better life for themselves. They're still trying to pursue the American dream.
We have a challenge from the new Obama administration, which is to increase completion and transfer rates of community colleges. The only way we can do this in this country is to make sure that we reach out and embrace all the students that we can and make them as successful as possible.
Accepting on behalf of Miami-Dade College is Ms. Malou Harrison. Congratulations, Miami-Dade. And last, but definitely not least, because I know Dr. Massey will get me if I say that, is the Power Plant Technology Institute at Indian River State College.
It's all about jobs. And thanks to a business and industry partnership between Indian River State College and Florida Power and Light, over 140 graduates have found high-wage employment in the nuclear industry. Since 2006, the Power Plant Technology Institute at IRSC has created a pipeline of highly skilled technicians. The formula is simple. Local students training for local jobs with the help of local industry.
I chose a career in nuclear energy because of the opportunities and the job openings that are going to be coming available. A lot of the people are retiring and they need young people to come in and take the jobs. There's so many different opportunities right in the plant to change careers or move up or try different things.
Housed in the new Brown Center for Innovation and Entrepreneurship, the Power Plant Technology Institute has access to a hands-on environment conducive to specialization training. IRSC, FPL, and the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, who provide subject matter expertise, share responsibility for oversight and quality of the Institute, with contextual learning, real-life job experience, and paid summer internships. This exemplary partnership has produced outstanding results. A student completion rate over 95%, an immediate hire rate above 90%, and starting salaries of $55,000 a year plus benefits. The program's success resulted in the establishment of the nation's first regional center for nuclear education and training, headquartered at Indian River State College. IRSC's partnership with FPL is a leading example of industry and education collaboration.
Let's congratulate Indian River State College in the area of workforce education. Accepting is Dr. Massey. Congratulations again to all of our 2012 Chancellor's Best Practice Awards.
Thank you to Chancellor Hannah and all those involved in that wonderful program. Now I'd like to bring back before you Jared Ferreira, the Florida President of Student Government, to bring us greetings from that organization. Jared, come on back up.
Thank you, everyone.
I want to first tell you how honored I am to be here today with all of you and to have the honor to speak in front of you. As a graduate of Pasco Hernando Community College and a first semester bachelor's student at St. Petersburg College, I can tell you firsthand how big of a role that you play in our students' lives and educations. We're more than just a college, we're a family. Something happens at our institutions that you just can't get from a university. And that's what each and every one of you brings to the table. That personal touch and pride that you bring to campus helps our students make it through the tough times and push through to graduation. Looking out here today and meeting some of you before this opening session started, I can guarantee that you all at least have one student in mind that you've connected with over the years. And whether or not you were able to provide them with some Yoda-style, sage-like advice, you have made an impact on their lives and education. So much so that there's a good chance that someday they're going to come back and work with you at one of these colleges. I travel around a lot to our 28 colleges throughout the state, and in some of my travels, as my mom says, I talk to a dead fish. I mingle with the staff. And in talking with them, majority of them at some point in time attended one of our colleges and have come back because we are just such lovely people. They want to work with us and be a part of what we do to make the future students' lives even better than theirs were. It's those little conversations before and after class, in the hallways, or after you just dodged an out-of-control golf cart that makes the students not just better students, but better people. And from the bottom of my heart and on behalf of the over 1 million students that we have across the state of Florida, I thank you. Give yourselves a round of applause.
I think we can have Jared on the program anytime. It's time for me to give my State of the Association address. My kids always tell me when I take my watch off, that's a problem. Don't worry, I just want to make sure I stay under our time limit. One of the things that I've learned this year as president is how amazingly broad and deep and extensive is the work of the Association of Florida Colleges. And as I've gone around and visited with folks at most of our campuses and looked at what we do, I can report to you with all pride and honesty that the state of the Association of Florida Colleges is excellent. I want to go through and just talk about some of the things that have taken place during the year. Some of these you're going to know about. Others may surprise you. And I want you to help me in a participatory manner as I go through this. If I put a slide up and talk about an event that you were at, I want you to stand for a moment and sit back down. Some of you are going to be standing a lot. Some maybe not quite so much. But these are some of the things that I've experienced that I think reflect the state of the association this year. Do you know that AFC helps to support the Council of Presidents as they meet each month all around the state? As your president, I'm privileged to attend those meetings and make a report on your behalf and bring back information from the Council of Presidents. President Pickens mentioned the work for continuing contract this year. And it was in one of those meetings that the Council of Presidents sort of gave us some idea of how we could be instructive in that discussion. Who's been to a Council of Presidents meeting? Stand up. Early in the year, our first commission meeting was our Trustees Commission. Over 100 of our trustees gathered in Tallahassee. Sean Alvashire, the chair of that committee, has done a wonderful job this year in organizing that group. Our trustees commission came and got valuable instruction about how to lead our colleges in those efforts. At that same event, we dedicated the Wall of Honor, which is now on the top floor of our AFC building, which recognized the presidents of the Magnificent 12, Florida's black junior colleges. Dr. Walter Smith, former president of FAMU, was there to talk to us about the history of that great heritage. In February, we gathered at the Mission Inn near my home to hold our own leadership conference and talk about ways to expand leadership in our membership. Who was at the membership conference? Are you standing up? See, I can't see. All righty. Thank you. You may want to just stand up when I show the slide because I can't see you anyway. Did you know that your executive committee meets 5 times during the year and many, many times over the phone or by email in between? That executive committee that you saw stand before you just a little while ago. Executive committee, stand up again. And beyond that, you have a board of directors that represents all of your regions, commissions, and special committees. They meet 4 times a year all over the state to represent you and make decisions about the financial and all sorts of decisions about our association. Thank you. Did you know that we and many of your college presidents and trustees and others attended the National Legislative Summit in Washington, D.C., where we talked about the needs of colleges at the national level? Did you know that AFC was a sponsor of Black, Brown, and College Bound at Hillsborough Community College? Marcia kind of represented us. Yeah, that's all right. Applaud these. Stand up. This is part of what you do. All right, now I expect some yelling for some of these next ones. Region 1 Spring Conference, sponsored by Tallahassee Community College. Kevin Petty led that effort. Region 3 Spring Conference, Daytona State College, Charlene Latimer. Region 4 Spring Conference, St. Petersburg College, Cheryl Peterson. So many volunteers, so many people make these happen. Did you know that AFC helped to sponsor the Connections Conference that was held at Santa Fe, where we talked about the needs of developmental students and how to connect them up and down the system? Region 2, Spring Conference, Santa Fe College again, led by Debbie McElroy. See, some of you standing up a lot. Who was at the Facilities Commission Conference at South Florida State College, led by Dr. Robert Flores? Did you know all this stuff was happening? Region 4 Spring Conference, Broward College, Chao Wang. Who was there? You know, I did that wrong before, and I never fixed the slide. Region 5, I'm sorry. It is Region 5. I know it's Region 5. I didn't fix the slide. We launched our Certified College Professionals program all over the state. There's a bunch of you out there. You should be standing up. The list is not done yet. We had a joint commissions conference in Tallahassee in May. A lot of commissions came together. Exemplary practice. Our chancellor spoke. Student Development Commission Conference in Orlando, Joe Cerubo, commission chair there. Here's one I bet a lot of you didn't know about. Did you know that AFC helps to support the Florida Association of Colleges and Universities, Independent Colleges and Universities of Florida? Dr. Johnson, Dr. Murdoch, Dr. Holden, and Dr. Curley are all involved in the leadership of that organization. Our legislative committee held a retreat this summer to begin the work of planning for next year's legislative session. Our legislative committee is here somewhere. Your bylaws committee, under the leadership of Bill Maloney, pulled that group together during the summer, and later in the week we'll be voting on new bylaw amendments. Did you know that AFC helps to sponsor the Chancellor's Leadership Seminar and is proud to be associated with that aspect of leadership here in our state? You know that we helped to sponsor an event at the American Association of Community Colleges at its national meeting in Orlando. Dr. McGee and Seminole State were there. Dr. Padron from Miami-Dade received an honor at that event, and we were there to represent you. Am I through yet? Almost. Your Association of Florida Colleges Foundation and its head, Andre Hawkins, has met and has continued the work of bursting our balloon to pay off the state building. Did you know that we were a sponsor of the Chair Academy that met here in Florida? Have you been involved in one of our many service projects across the state, at chapters, regions, and here at convention? We had our membership conference in July. Dr. Alex Perez, membership committee, and all those who were in attendance there. And finally today, and this week, we're here for the 63rd annual AFC conference. Did you know that that much happened during the course of the year? How could we say that the state of the association is anything but excellent after that list of accomplishments? I also think we've gone a long way to meeting the goals that I established as I began the year. I tried to make them manageable. I wanted us to launch the Certified College Professional Program, and I'm proud to say that tomorrow night we will celebrate our first graduates of that program. I wanted us to strengthen the message and the work of our AFC commissions, and your Commission Vice President, Joe Wallace, has done a wonderful job of helping to pursue that. If you haven't signed up to do a short video in support of your commission, I want to see you do that. My final goal was that we would reach 10,000 members in 2012. I didn't think we were going to make that in 2012, and we're not quite there, but we're going to support President Byron Todd in the next year to finally reach that goal as well. My motto for the year has been many dreams, one future. And I always think about individual students and their stories when I think about our work. I think about a student in my class this semester named Mike. Mike dropped out of school in the eighth grade. He's about my age now, and after many years of working in industry and finding that he always got to a place where he had to either speak or write, and he felt uncomfortable doing so, that it was time for him to quit his job and go back to work and get a degree. But that's not the whole story for Mike. After about 8 weeks of the semester, he decided he didn't have what it takes, and he was about ready to drop out. But between the counselors and his friends and me as instructor, we talked him into staying, and Mike's going to do just fine. We represent the future. We represent the dreams of not just the students that we have in our classrooms right now, but of the future of the state of Florida. And I'm so very proud to have been your spokesman this year for this great association. Please give yourselves another round of applause for what you do. A few more things I want to say before we get to our speeches and our candidates for office. If this is your first convention, would you please stand and let us welcome you. Very glad that you're here and hope you will take full advantage of all that these days have to offer. You won't be disappointed. Learn from your colleagues, make friends, and find ways to incorporate what you learn and take it back to your college. With more than 48 professional development sessions to choose from, you will learn something. As you must know, there's a tremendous amount of work that goes into these annual conventions. To accomplish all the jobs that take place before, during, and after the convention, we need to recognize individuals who have served. If you are a part of any of the regional committees that have helped to provide leadership and volunteerism throughout this convention, if you've helped with meal table reservations, decorations, name badges, operations, internet room, door prizes, and all the other jobs that are associated with the convention, would you please stand and accept our thanks? Stand up. And it's already been said, but I also want to thank our friends from St. Petersburg College and from Pasco Hernando Community College who serve as our host colleges and who have assisted us in so many ways in making this happen. If you're from one of those two schools, stand up and hear our applause. It's all of our work together that makes this a wonderful opportunity. Finally, in terms of recognition, I want you to see your board of directors, the folks from all across the state who come together and listen to some mighty long meetings to talk about what we need to do. If you're a member of the board of directors for the Association of Florida Colleges, please stand and receive our applause.
Let's give Gary one more round of applause for his many years of service to this association. At this time, we'd like to highlight a few individuals who have assisted in making this association great, as Gary has described. And these are people that are going to be recognized this afternoon with our most prestigious honor that the association can bestow upon a member, the Honorary Life Membership Award. Our first recipient has a 23-year history with AFC and is known at her college for her long-standing commitment and outstanding service to the association. She served 6 times as chapter president of her chapter. She served 10 years as chapter treasurer and was the chapter's unsung hero in 1997, 2002, and 2006, and the Region 2 Deputy Director in 2010 and 11, and Region 2 Director in 2011. This recipient has been a member of the Career and Professional Employees Commission for 13 years and has served as its treasurer for 10 of those. As you can see, there really isn't much she hasn't done as a member of the AFC. A stalwart of the Florida Gateway College Chapter, it is my distinct honor to present Ms. Frances Ash with the AFC Honorary Life Membership. Whoever's operating the scroll needs to slow down. It's way ahead of me. All right. Now, this one, we try to keep these secret, as you can tell by Francis's completely shocked and overwhelmed. And I wish we could keep this next one secret to the very last sentence, but I know that by the second sentence of my description, we're going to give it away. Our next recipient through the years has provided mentoring advice and support to fellow AFC members statewide.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing? All right. The next recipient throughout the years has provided mentoring advice and support to fellow AFC members statewide. With his working knowledge of legislative issues. As a retired decorated military veteran in the 90s, he worked closely with then Representative John Thrasher and ultimately served as Representative Thrasher's senior executive assistant from 1992 to 2000, including time while Representative Thrasher was the Speaker of the House. Although this recipient was not at the time a representative of the Florida college system, he worked alongside the Speaker and was an advocate for education in support of the governor's education reform initiatives. In 2000, he officially joined the Florida college system, and we've been benefiting from his presence ever since. As an AFC member for more than 12 years, his chapter and others have come to depend on him to relay the legislative facts in layman's terms. Known by his fellow legislative comrades as Rollout Roy, he annually hosts a series of legislative updates for faculty, staff, and administration. These events are highly attended and greatly valued by the campus community. As on a more basic note, but no less important level, he is someone who at the AFC chapter offices know to turn to year after year for assistance on any task. Whether called upon to sell raffle tickets, recruit new members, or man a booth, he responds to each request with an immediate yes, just tell me how you need me to help out. He also served last year as the chair of the AFC Legislative Committee, and I'm very, very proud to serve with him as my colleague and my very good friend. Let's please recognize Mr. Jim Roy of St. John's River State College, AFC Honorary Life Member. Our next recipient is a well-respected former legislator, Senate Minority Leader, confidant to various governors, successful businessman and lobbyist with a reputation for the highest ethical standards. He has been a supporter of the Florida College system, has lobbied for the system, the association, and has provided advice to us, the Council of Presidents, as well as many, many individual college presidents. First elected to the Senate in 1967, he was only 27 years old. This made him one of the youngest members ever elected in Florida to the state Senate. He served in the Senate from 1967 through 1978 legislative session. After leaving the legislature, this recipient returned to Tallahassee and worked as a lobbyist for many, many different clients. Among those clients has been the Association of Florida Colleges and our Council of Presidents. Most recently, his background and expertise a couple years ago about the Florida retirement system allowed him to effectively lobby effectively with us and on our behalf to minimize the impact of the FRS changes a couple years ago to you. In recognition of his influence and the high regard in which he was held among legislative leaders, he was asked to work behind the scenes to review and to recommend what changes should be made on those proposed retirement bills. Thanks to his vast history and knowledge of FRS, the legislature, and the Florida college system, we were successful in our lobbying efforts that year. And we owe a great debt of gratitude to the Honorable Ken Plant. Unfortunately, Ken is recovering from an illness and could not be with us today, and we will present him with his award at the Trustees Legislative Conference in Tallahassee. Please let's give Senator Plant a rousing round of applause. Finally, our final recipient's tenure in AFC is impressive, both for her service at the local level and her service statewide. Since 1996, she has served AFC in a variety of leadership positions at the chapter, region, and state levels. These include Vice President of Regions and Chapters, State Awards Committee Chair, Region 1 Chair, Chapter President, Treasurer, Secretary, Concessions Chair, Publicity Chair, and many, many others. She is truly Miss AFC. There isn't much about AFC she doesn't know. If she's asked to do it, consider it done. During her tenure as the association's president, the groundwork began for our new leadership program, the Certified College Professional. Her goal was to establish a leadership program in the association that would provide all college employees, regardless of their position at their institution, the opportunity to build their leadership skills and be recognized for their talent and commitment to their college and the Florida college system. Over the years, this recipient has gathered a reputation for having the need to shop. Now, what you may not know about her is that she's a home goods addict. During her year as president, she found and shopped in every home goods store in the state of Florida, and she doesn't know that, but I have seen her in the Tallahassee store on more than one occasion that just opened very recently. Known for driving while reading, she has visited your chapters and regions, fortunately arriving safely, and she has also completed in that drive a novel, a Sudoku puzzle, and research for whatever publication project she is working on at the present time. Over the last 10 years, she has designed logos and themes for nearly every incoming AFC president. Her dedication and commitment to this association is unfailing. She is more than our immediate past president. She is an AFC treasure. It is my distinct honor to present an AFC honorary life membership to our 2011 president and current past president, Ms. Evelyn Ward from Chipola College.
Ignore that sign thing that happened there. Congratulations to all of our award recipients. We thank our honorees for the great work you have done on behalf of the AFC and of our colleges. And now I'm going to ask Evelyn Ward to come back up to give the statewide nominating committee report. Evelyn.
At the September Board of Directors meeting, the nominating committee presented four names to the Board of Directors for approval as candidates for the state office for 2013. They are Vice President-elect for Regions and Chapters, Dr. Xiao Wang from Broward College, Vice President-elect for Commissions, Ms. Wanda Curtis, Miami-Dade College, and Ms. Alice Seary from Indian River State College. And for President-elect, Mr. Peter Usinger from Polk State College. We want to thank all of our candidates for agreeing to serve.
Okay, since we're in the meeting and we need to consider these candidates, in just a moment I'll ask for a motion to accept the slate of candidates. Understand that we will also open the floor for nominations. Do I hear a motion to accept the slate of candidates as read? Do I have a second? All in favor of accepting the slate of candidates as presented, say aye. Any opposed? I will now go through the slate and ask for nominations from the floor. Please remember that any candidate nominated from the floor must already have his or her college president's approval. I now open the floor for nominations for the office of vice president-elect for regions and chapters. Hearing none, the slate of candidates for the position of vice president-elect for regions and chapters stands. I now open the floor for nominations for the office of vice president-elect for commissions. Hearing none, the slate of candidates for the position of vice president-elect for commissions stands. The floor is now open for nominations for the office of president-elect. Hearing none, the slate of candidates for the position of president-elect stands. I would now like to call on Evelyn Ward again to present the candidates for office.
Before we begin our presentations by the candidates, I'd like to remind everyone that our speeches are limited to a maximum of 5 minutes. I'd also like to remind delegates, if you have been selected a delegate by your college, that voting for our state offices will take place Friday morning from 7 a.m. until 8:15 a.m. in Inverness Hall. Now I'd like to call on the candidates for the position of Vice President-elect for Regions and Chapters. Our first is Dr. Xiao Wang of Broward College. Xiao.
Thank you, Evelyn. Good afternoon, dear AFC friends and colleagues. My name is Xiao Wang, and I'm running for the vice president-elect for regions and chapters. I'm so honored and happy to be here today. AFC is the professional organization that embraces all members in the Florida college system. I'm running for the VP-elect for regions and chapters because I strongly believe that regions and chapters are the foundation of AFC in promoting AFC values and in recruiting members. I'm so proud to be part of this great organization. Since I joined AFC 8 years ago, I have served in different AFC capacities, such as campus vice president, chapter president, region director, region 5 judge for professor of the year, member of the AFC board of the directors, and the editorial board member for the AFC Vision Journal Vision. If elected, I will focus on important areas such as membership and professional development by working tirelessly with passionate, dedicated, and talented leaders and members like all of you. Together, we can ensure our students' success in a great Florida college system. The following is a brief presentation. Thank you for your support.
One of the great things about her is that she tends to think things out very clearly, and she likes to be very precise and clear and concise. And you have to be that if you're going to be vice president-elect for commissions.
Wanda has been working with me for about over a year now, and she's been a terrific assistant to the chairperson.
She is loyal. She believes in education for everyone, no matter what their age is. And I believe that she would make a major contribution in that position.
As a new adjunct faculty member here at the Miami-Dade College West Campus, she has been a pillar for me to rely upon.
She has that mentality where she just wants to help everybody. There's not anybody that she's not willing to help if they're willing to put in work also.
The vice president of the commission should be knowledgeable and have a hands-on approach to the policies and procedures of the AFC.
Because of the leadership and energy she brings, she loves AFC with a passion.
And she is a believer in people more than processes.
She's a great mentor. I believe that if she gets this position, there wouldn't be any problems.
But most of all, because she loves AFC.
Wanda Curtis is one of those people that you don't really meet nowadays.
Who has excellent communication styles, who cares about others, and who has a high degree of professionalism and a very strong work ethic.
I believe that she possesses wonderful interpersonal skills.
One of the best advocates for AFC.
She keeps me focused and she keeps me coordinated. And one of the major responsibilities of this position, as we all know, is to coordinate events.
All of those qualities, Wanda Curtis has them hands down. She would be an ideal candidate. She embodies all of those types of qualities.
She's the perfect person for this position.
Thank you. We all have a need in our lives to belong. Belonging is not a want, it is a need that puts us in contact with the world outside ourselves. Whether we connect with others at home, at work, or within our community, the sense of accomplishment and reward one feels belonging to something is priceless. These value systems are a great part of why I am here today as members of the Association of Florida Colleges, and undoubtedly a major part of who I am as a person and why I wish to further serve in this great organization. My AFC spirit has been contagious to colleagues at MDC on a personal level and through my professional career as assistant chair of academic services at Miami-Dade College West. Looking back, my grandmother was a great influence in my life. From early on, she saw leadership skills in me. Her spirit lives on within me today, and I have incorporated these words to be more empowered, to make a difference through service and leadership. Let's concentrate on the good that we can accomplish and fill ourselves with courage no matter what comes our way. Indeed, the relevance of this philosophy and approach resonated within me in light of a recent unexpected tragedy where a new construction site came tumbling down at Miami-Dade College's West Campus. We lost the lives of some of our construction team that day, and this event has affected and challenged each and every one of us at the college, faculty, staff, and students alike. Throughout this terrible incident, I was sadly reminded of how fragile life really is. Simultaneously, this event has also shown us, through actions, the power of coming together, making us resilient and hopeful towards a common cause. My plan is to continue to build upon the resources created by past VPs, as well as seek more opportunities for continued growth. That power in unity, that strength in purpose, is above all what brings me to you today to ask for your support to serve as Vice President-elect for commissions. I will step up to achieve even greater things, and I will make a difference through service, inclusion, and leadership. That is my promise to you, the members of the Association of Florida Colleges. Thank you. Our next candidate for the Vice President-elect of Commissions is Ms. Alice Siri of Indian River State College. Alice.
Hi, I'm Alice Siri, and I'm running for Vice President of Commissions. My experience in AFC has provided me with the skills and the knowledge that are necessary to be successful in this role. I chose The Wizard of Oz as the opening to this presentation, partly because it is the theme of this convention, but primarily because it illustrates my belief that to participate, members have to be as comfortable in an organization as they are at home. I've been a member of AFC for 29 years. At first, I wasn't active. I went to meetings locally because they had a good cheap lunch. But I wasn't really comfortable doing more. I didn't see the need to do more. Although I'm a faculty member, I first became involved with AFC through the Student Development Commission. In applying for their Exemplary Practice Award, and then in doing the presentations that encompass that, I came to become more comfortable in the commissions and in AFC as a whole. I've attended many local, regional, and statewide meetings where membership was discussed. The one question that always comes up from potential members is, what's in it for me? I think the answer to that is in the commissions. In the commissions, there is a group where every college employee can meet with others in the same job, they have the same focus, and they can discuss their ideas and concerns. This is my idea of a slide that could be included on the AFC webpage. For those of you that don't know, this is the actual AFC building in Tallahassee. If you click on one of the letters, what you will get right now is a listing of officers for this commission. However, all levels of college employees need to continuously update knowledge and skills. The new website can also include links to exemplary practices and best practices. As Healthcare Education Commission Chair, I've been investigating the possibility of offering CEUs and certifications through the website. I know the Facilities Commission has already begun this. They have a model that may be able to be replicated for all commissions. Professional development will be my primary goal as Vice President of Commissions. I would work well with Christina Wells, the incoming Chair, Vice President of Commissions, as this is her primary goal as well. Another goal would be to increase the awareness and participation in awards and honors. Information needs to be disseminated sooner to allow participants sufficient time to apply. These are two of my goals, but I would be interested in what members who can't attend conventions say. I'd like to conduct a survey to determine the needs and goals of these members. Once complete, we can then may need to revise my goals, but I'm willing to work with the membership to do just that. Basically, we all share many of the same issues. Let's provide an atmosphere of open communication that occurs in addition to the commission meetings at convention. We can empower members through technology and the new website to become more involved in their organization. All it would take is awareness of the simple technology available and to create an atmosphere of sharing. I've been working with Mike Pelletier in IT at Indian River to investigate simple state-of-the-art technology that can increase communication among members. By doing that, we will also increase the feeling of community, which is one of the AFC values. In just a second, I'm going to show you a sample of one of these. It is a small 10-second video where you can have audio, video recordings and provide a personal message that is more personal than just reading an email. So let's empower AFC members by providing them with the tools to share ideas, concerns, and resolutions, and the comfort level to do so. This was recorded in my office. It's a first take. It's not perfect, but it's realistic.
One of the ideas that we all have in common when we think of home is the comfort level that you feel sharing ideas and concerns with those around you, whether it's the home of your childhood or the home we built as an...
Not my rules. Don't shoot the messenger. Our candidate for the position of president-elect, Mr. Peter Usinger from Polk State College. Peter.
Wow, you need sunglasses up here. Yesterday at the college, there were, I talked to 10, about 10, 15 people, and about 9 out of 10 had election stress disorder. I'm so glad that this election, our election is, yeah, I know, you know what I'm talking about. I'm so glad that this election is not pitching people against each other, but for each other. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Peter Usinger, and I want to be your president-elect. And this is a German accent. I came over the big pond 22 years ago, but my vocal cords are still sort of like in the old mode in some fashion or another. Since 10 years, I work at Polk State College, and almost as long, I'm a proud member of this association. When I moved to Florida, I never thought I would find such a great family at Polk State, and an even greater extended family at this association, but I did. The main reason, you all are awesome. You are an awesome group of people who, like me, care about education. And you show that care through the work that you do and through the values that we share and you share. Just imagine and think about it, what would happen without you and without our colleagues at home? There would be no Florida college system that helps students succeed against all odds. Without you, there would be much, much smaller amount of families being proud of their first kid at college. Without you, many, many local businesses, hospitals, and services would wonder where to find the qualified graduates that help them serve their communities. I'm so proud of the work that you do. I'm so proud of the work that we all do. So thank you, and thank you for being here, celebrating our service together, celebrating this community of colleges that we are, and celebrating the AFC and its important role. But celebrating is one thing, getting ready for the next political dance is another. We live in challenging times, particularly when it comes to education. There are so many uncertainties. State funding, financial aid, student enrollment, facilities maintenance, federal mandates, the performance of the K-12 system, to name just a few. It makes one thing clear to me. We cannot master those challenges without each other. We have to become an even stronger community of colleges to help our students succeed. We have to become an even smarter community of professionals to do better. And we have to be even a stronger AFC and an even more effective AFC to help leading the way for better education and academic opportunity for everyone in this state. Together with our students, we are the beating heart of the Florida colleges. And together with our colleagues, and with every heartbeat and throughout what we do and the communities that we serve, our communities get a better chance for a better future. That's what I believe, and that's why I want to serve as your president-elect. So what do you think, what qualifies me to do so? My involvement with the AFC has been for the last 10 years in many, many events, and I know the functioning of the board. I have been 2 times commission chair. I have been on the board of directors, and I think the connections inside, 1 minute, thank you. I don't want to be cut off, that is, and so gives me a good insight in the workings of the organization. And at the college, I'm in charge of many facets of institutional effectiveness, planning, research, accreditation, a broad spectrum of knowledge that helps me to really understand all the workings of the organizations and how they connect, and what they mean for our communities. And last but not least, as many of you might know, after hours, I'm very good at dancing with the stars and sometimes without them. And I hope we can continue this dance together. And thank you. Have a good evening.
Thank you, Peter. That concludes the presentations from our candidates. I would like to encourage everyone to become involved in AFC. I'm going to add to this. I encourage everyone to consider a leadership role in AFC. The people who have spoke to you today, those of us who have spoke to you in past years, are no different than you. We have everyday jobs just like you do, and we have roles. Some of us are administrators, some of us are faculty members, and some of us, like myself, are career employees. The sky's the limit in the leadership opportunities at AFC, and I hope everyone here will consider taking this step and running for office in the future. And this convention will provide you a great opportunity to talk to one of us that's either a past leader or a current leader if you have any questions about it. Thank you very much for your participation.
Don't forget to join us next door at our exhibitors' welcome reception. Wait a minute. What's that I hear off in the distance?
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow, 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 follow the yellow brick road.
All right, everybody on your feet. Let's head out to the exhibition hall. Follow our...
You're off to see the wizards, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. You'll find he is a wizard of wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, ever a wiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one because of the wonderful things he does. You're off to see the wizards, the wonderful